Hello everyone, welcome to EduSys. This video will help you in understanding the flow of EduSys College Management software. Once we do the setup, you will be getting the login credentials, username and password to your registered email ID or mobile number. If you does not receive the credentials even after the setup is over, you can reach our support team. Also, you can create your own password using forget password option in the login page. Now, you browse and enter the URL as www.edusys.co/edusyscollege to open the login page. Use your credentials to log in into the application. So, let us start with the flow of the application now. We need to go to the College Master, click on application setting. Now, select the department and designation screen. In the department and designation, we have department screen where you can add all the department present in the institution like IT department, accounts department or etc. Note, first we have to configure academic badge like student slash staff cannot be registered without academic basic configuration. Let us start academic badge configuration. First, go to academic setting, open the academic badge screen, click on plus icon and configure the basic academic badge details. Select academic degree, degree group, etc. from existing drop-downs. If the exact degree group is not available, click on the degree group button. The degree group button is present in the main window right corner and configure the degree groups. Select batch from year and to year as their batch slash course duration. If degree course is to be managed by a specific department, then select specific department like EEE, ECE, IT department in the drop-down list of managed by department. This is optional. If course slash degree is NBA specific accreditation, then only checklist OBE specific checkbox. Academic year table will be enabled based on only a checklist OBE specific checkbox. Academic year table will be enabled based on the selection of the course duration shown from year to year selection. If degree is semester wise, we can split the year into semester by just checklisting the checkbox in the is semester wise. We can split the year into semester by just number of semesters from one academic year. Maximum semesters will be 5 in a year. After that, we can give the start date and end date, start time and end time of the academic year. Once the semester settings are done, then set the year type of for generated course year. We have 3 year types, namely currently year, previous year and next year. Let us take an example for 2019 to 23 batch. The first year we will be 2019 to 20. Academic year will be current year. And second, third, fourth year will be next year. For 2018-22 batch, the first year of the batch 2018 to 19 will be previous year. And the second year will be 19-20 will be the current year. And third and fourth year will be next year. So choose accordingly. Hope you understood. Once the academic badge is configured, then current year will reflect in blue color and the previous year will reflect in the pink color and next year will reflect in the green color. If your institution has any specified set of roll numbers, then you can append the prefix in roll number prefix column. Also, you should set the maximum length of roll number. There should be at least 3 categories difference in roll number prefix and roll number max length. You can even give the max credit of one semester slash year minimum pass credits, which is to be gained by the student for promoting to the next year. Permitted backlogs for the year can also be configured. Also, select the shift type for the particular academic batch. We can also create academic batch through bulk import option. We can download the Excel sheets and can maintain the data in the particular format, and we can upload the data at the time. In load Excel sheet, by giving details in the mandatory fields, we can create new academic batches. Mandatory columns, headings are in green column, optional. Fields can also be filled, data is available. Note, once academic batch creation is done, then you can register the staff in staff management screen. In the user management module and student admission screen in the college setup module. User registration module, if you want to do that later, then you can continue with the configurations like subjects, sections, etc. in the academic setup. Next step, student admissions, college setup, user registration, student admissions. In this screen, we can add the student admission details like personal details, family details, language proficiency, admissions enrolling information, uploading the documents submitted by the student at the time of admissions, etc. Any number of students can be registered based on the availability of the seats, and their details can be modified by school officials at any time. Once the application status of a student is confirmed, no changes can be made in the admission information. However, we can use student management screen for adding or updating more information of the student. Click on Add User icon to add the new student admission details. Enter all the required data and save the data in the field to register the students. Asterisk symbol fields are mandatory. It's optional to fill the data other than mandatory fields. In enrolling information, we will be selecting the student admission info, such as for which academic year they are enrolling, degree code and course year. Student photo can be uploaded using upload photo option and document using document uploading option in the screen. Transportation and dormitory facilities can be assigned to the student by enabling bus and dormitory buttons. By default, we will be providing one application type in the drop-down. If you need more types in the drop-down, just configure in the master settings by selecting inquiry types. Similarly, while selecting the option types in the family details, to get data in the drop-down list, you have to add new types in the master settings screen. Once the application status is confirmed, a notification will be sent automatically to the registered mobile number or email ID that register has been successfully done. For sending the notification, go to notification screen, like go to campus master, application master, notification templates. You can create whatever template you want to create here or the content you want to mention, and then go to next screen, notification alert master, and you have to checklist here whatever notification you want to send and how to send to the student, then it will go automatically. Use bulk import option if there are a large number of students. Go to campus master, child admission, Mask sure Excel sheet in the load run report to check the error for the detailed records. You can make appropriate changes for the filed records and reload or import again. Next step is staff management. As a super admin, you will be assigning the work to the different staff according to their roles and designation. So now we have to go to the department and designation screen, configure before registering the staff. First is department configuration, which we have explained previously also. Next, we have to give designations here. In the designation screen, here we can add all the available designations in the designation alias, and also we can configure teaching plan details for the staff in the staff management screen only for whose job designation has is teaching option enabled. Next, we have department designation mapping screen. Here you need to map under which department the designation should be. Third step, staff management. User management, staff management. Personal profile. In this screen, we can manage staff personal details. This screen is used to register the staff, enter all the required data and save the data in the fields to register the staff. It's optional to fill the data other than mandatory fields. Staff can be assigned to the departments based on their specifications. Management can register the staff just clicking on Add Single User button beside Add User. Use Bulk Import option. If there is a large number of staff, make sure Excel sheet is in the proper format to ensure importing the data without error. You can even download the load run report to check the errors for the filed records. You can make appropriate changes for the filed records and reload or import again. While registering staff, if you have not specified the genuine email ID, then application will generate automated email ID for each staff. You can reset the password in the user maintenance screen. Next step, role authorizations. In this screen, we can give access to the screens to the users based on their user role in the branch level. Next step, role authorizations. In this screen, we can give access of a screen to the users based on their user roles in the branch level. We can even give an access as a read-only and read and write also. For the selected screens, custom user authorization. Here we can give access to the screens username wise by choosing the department for the selected modules and screens. Username wise or individually faculty wise. Now let us go back to the academic setup to complete further configurations. Subject management. Go to academic setup. Subject management screen. In this screen, we add list of subjects for the individual course year belonging to the respective degree codes. This can be done individually by selecting plus icon and enter data for the required fields. You can select the subject type as elective or non-elective as well. Based on the subject, we can keep the subject group as language, first, second language, etc., which can be selected from the drop-down list. To include one particular subject into the timetable, then enable include in timetable option. You can also specify number of credits for that particular subject. Make sure the total credits of all subjects assigned for the course year should not exceed maximum credit count of that course year. If management has decided to assign different subjects in one time slot, then include those particular subjects into different groups. We cannot include theory and other subjects into the groups. Management can also update the number of hours to be spent for each subject. Create subject details can be edited using edit option in the action column. Management can also delete multiple subjects at a time. Management can also dump all the subject list at once using Excel sheet present in input. Fill the information in the Excel sheet with given format and upload and process the file. Then all the subjects will be dumped into the screen, which takes less than 5 seconds. Management can view count of success records, failed records, and total records of the file. Even student admission is confirmed, they need to be assigned to a particular section. Then only we can see them in the student management screen for any data to be added or reflected to the student. Now we are going to do section management. Then student to section management. First, section management. In this screen, we create number of sections for the particular degree code and course year. They can also define the maximum strength, maximum students to be allotted to a section for the created sections. For one course year, duplicate sections are not acceptable. You can configure the sections by clicking the plus icon, enter the data in the mandatory fields. Primary and secondary course year faculty can also be assigned to monitor the students in the sections. Secondary faculty can act as a backup in the absence of primary faculty. Next, student to section. After sections are created, now in this screen, we assign the students to respective sections. In student admission screen, once student admission is confirmed, then student will reflect in the student to section screen, unassigned screen. You can see unassigned students for the selected degree code and course year. To assign all the students to a section at a time, then click checklist box, which is available in select column. If you want assign few students to the sections, then enable the checkbox for individual student. After selecting the students, now select the sections from allocate to the section drop down and save. Here ends with the flow of the application. Thank you.